Welcome to Conversations with Leaders. My name is Miriam McLemore, and I'm an enterprise strategist with AWS. I am thrilled today to have some time to speak with Igor Tsyganskiy, who is the CTO of Bridgewater. Welcome to the program, Igor.
Great to be here.
Igor, let's jump in. Could you give us a snapshot of Bridgewater and your role there?
Bridgewater is the largest hedge fund in the world. We manage more than $150 billion for institutions around the world. Some of them are pension funds, endowment funds, sovereign wealth funds, as well as governmental organizations. As an organization, we think about timeless and universal rules that drive monetary flows around the world. We then export those rules into code and into our software systems that then, while supervised by us, invest money into most of the markets in almost every country around the world.
Compared to most financial institutions, Bridgewater has been often an early adopter of new technologies. Can you tell us a little bit about your approach to technology adoption?
We always have to be on the edge of technology, since the world is always changing and the rules about how the world works get more and more complex. Having more compute power in a more flexible way is almost required for us to continue running our business. So about 10 years ago, we were early adopters. We partnered with AWS, and we were early adopters of using AWS to provide us with mission-critical elastic compute to calculate our timeless and universal rules. That created a huge wave of innovation inside of Bridgewater that allowed us to scale our understanding of what's going on by more than 1,000x in the last 5 years. We believe that that created and allowed us to continue being in the business and to continue innovating.
Your use particularly of cloud technology is an interesting story. Can you share a little bit about that as well?
We've partnered with AWS about 6 years ago. Some of the challenges that we were facing is our ability, as I've mentioned before, our ability to grow data centers was pretty impaired compared to the need that the business had for both elastic and flexible compute. We also needed to respond to ever-changing challenges of cyber risk that are now a lot greater than they were 5 or 6 years ago. I believe that we've had an amazing relationship where both of our companies had a chance of growing up together. And we helped AWS learn and what it means to run mission-critical applications and workloads. And AWS actually provided us all the scale that we needed in the world. It's been an amazing relationship in that way.
So in these unprecedented times that we're all living in, Bridgewater was able to continue to serve its customers without disruption. Was that based on this technology adoption that you had made?
We've shifted to working from home 18 to 24 months ago and have been working without any interruptions, essentially virtually, for all that time. We were also able to shift to supporting our customers virtually using AWS without interruptions, and that is just amazing. Not only we were faced with the needs of COVID, but also we were faced with the fact that markets have been most volatile over the last 18 months or so. And our increase in compute demand have by and large grown by about 3x at times, and at peak has grown about 10x. That is an unprecedented need for elastic compute that even 10 years ago we were not able to satisfy. And only via our partnership with AWS we were able to do this. And this is one of the reasons I'm doing this interview, is to highlight on how grateful we are for the partnership and the work that we've done together over this period of time.
And so compute, for obvious reasons then, is absolutely critical, right?
Absolutely. Compute is most critical. It's one of the most important elements to enable Bridgewater operating successfully on an ongoing basis. especially when the markets are volatile or when the world is changing so much. Our ability to compute these timeless and universal rules is of utmost importance.
And you've described before, I've heard you talk about the importance of partnership and kind of how you define that. Can you share a little bit about your thoughts on partnering?
Listen, effective partnering is interdependence on the parties working together. Not everything can always go great. And supporting each other at the time of need is what partnership is all about. Partnership is in Bridgewater's DNA. We don't look at our customers as customers, we look at them as partners. We're there to support them at the time of need. And we don't look at our vendors as vendors, we look at them as partners. We support them when they need our support, and we believe they support us. The best vendors support us when we need support. And that has come true absolutely in the last 18 months, where we have gotten all the support that we needed from AWS to provide us with stable, continuous compute and availability at the most critical times.
Tell us about how you make technology investment decisions.
For Bridgewater, making technology investment decisions, first and foremost, means to understand what business impact one wants to achieve. One of the things that I've done is assemble a technology advisory committee here at Bridgewater that consists of some of the luminaries in computer industry, as well as cybersecurity. Craig Mundy, Keith Alexander, Adam Bosworth, and some others. First, we fully, deeply go through the process of understanding of what business impact we want. And then we evaluate pretty much all the technologies, whether they're external, or we evaluate the opportunity to build the technology internally in order to satisfy those business needs. Having the wisdom and the discussion with the technology advisory board helps me figure out which road to take and which partners to go and choose. And it's that for that collaborative process, together with the employees, we decide on how to choose our next investments. Sometimes the technology is differentiating and it's very important, but when it comes down to the fact that multiple companies might have similar technology, our ability to partner with a company becomes very, very important. And figuring out who we're gonna bet on is an important choice and becomes almost paramount towards making big technology bets.
Yeah, no, I love that, and the outside in and the inside out view that you have. Any advice, Igor, that you would have to technology leaders or business leaders looking to adopt cloud and transforming their business?
Well, I would tell them to let go of their fear and worries and just take the plunge, move to the cloud. It's one of the best things that we've done at Bridgewater, and every single company should consider doing the same. There are many reasons on why one should worry about moving to the cloud, but there are even so many more reasons on why one should be in the cloud. The notion of elastic compute, the notion of ever-changing needs of cybersecurity is something one cannot just do by themselves. Companies in a current environment are hopeless in trying to figure out on how to move and evolve without tight partnership with companies like Amazon. I strongly suggest for everyone to consider moving to the cloud, to make their decisions, to first think about on why they should do it and think about how can they solve the problems that they have versus focusing on the problems that they have and essentially saying, well, we cannot do it because of the problems that we have. Talent of the future is not willing to work in environments that are legacy and old, which creates in itself a self-fulfilling prophecy of being able to move forward and keep up with computing evolution.
Igor, thank you so much for that, for your insights, for your time, and for your partnership. We so much appreciate you and Bridgewater.